Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you guys having a Hyundai Sonata. Guys, you need to remove or replace door lock actuator or exterior door handle assembly. For either of those, you have to guys okay do the same amount of work. So stay with us, we'll explain how to do that step by step, and it will show you guys very detailed information, because otherwise you can damage components in the door that can cost you quite a bit of money. Before we start, let me just tell you a little bit about us guys. Every single car we get here at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these absolutely free videos. If you need to buy any parts, tools for a good price and quick shipping, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can save quite a bit of money. So let's go ahead and start on it now. So next step, it's a little bit nasty looking guys, okay, it's a little bit nasty looking, it's a parts car that we'll be demonstrating on. So what do you need to do? Now, first thing, we need to remove gently the cover for the mirror, okay, just gently pry it out. Be careful, okay, not to break it, perfect, just like that. Three clips, okay, let me show you three clips. They go, okay, in this hose right here. Now, right here under that handle, we have a cover. Okay, that cover right here. All we have to do, okay, get a screwdriver, okay, and pry it on the back or the front side, and it will come out. This one was actually loose. Underneath, there is one screw, okay, with a Phillips screwdriver, okay, that we need to remove, okay, right here. So, let's go ahead, do that, okay, see if it's going to come out. Or we will need to get a regular screwdriver, probably. No, I don't think it will work. So let's get a screwdriver, we'll remove that one. It's important to remove it, otherwise you will not be able to remove the door panel. So let's go ahead, it's pretty tight. Then there is one more that's hidden, guys. Now for a 2010-2015 generation, it's pretty simple design. There is one cap right here. Okay, that cap, you can see it is in the handle. So I need to get the flathead screwdriver. Okay, and you pry it, guys. Okay, you go in the thing. Okay, like that. You pry it and it comes up. Okay, perfect. Now, another screwdriver, it's so dirty here, I don't know even if the screwdriver will catch the screw. Perfect. Next. We need to go ahead, okay, and pull the screw out to make sure it's not holding. Now, at that point, check everywhere else, but we should have no screws, okay, holding anymore. The only thing that we need, guys, is a prying tool. And now we have multiple clips, and once we remove the door panel, we will explain where exactly each clip is located. That way, you will know where to apply pressure, okay, so you don't break anything. Okay, check it out, it's coming loose. Even if you get your finger sometimes underneath it, it can help. Here, I think you'll need to lift it up a little bit to come out, okay. And now we need to disconnect all the cables. So, now, how we can do that now, guys? Okay, there are actually a few things that we can do. We can remove the interior door handle right here, okay, or let me see if we will be able to disconnect the cables like that. You press down here and you pull it out. Now something fell, I will see what it is. Looks like, okay, that door handle is broken on the inside. That's a piece, okay, right here for the lock, it looks like, lock and unlock as well. Now we need to disconnect the wiring harness for the mirror switch. So let me see. Okay, it's right here. Okay, that thing, let me show you now. That thing here in the middle, you press down, you pull it out. Same thing on this side. Don't put any, no, go down a little bit, not to have pressure on the wire. The same thing, guys. Okay, right here, you press in, you pull out. One wire right here. Okay, and the door panel came out, you can see, just like that. Now the clips, okay, let's explain where the clips are. A few clips didn't remove, one of them here. So get it with the clip removal tool, and we're going to install it on the door panel. And now all the clips that are here, okay, you start with here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 clips here, guys. And I don't think there is more holding that panel. If you need to buy replacement clips, we'll put the link in the description of the video below where you can get some from. Next step, we're going to install the key. Then we need to install the window switch, and we'll need to bring the window down. Okay, let's install the window switch quick. Okay, perfect. This is guys the wiring harness, okay, for the window switch. And next, okay, all we have to do now is we're going to remove those caps, rubber caps right here. There should be one more over there, okay, so one here, one over there. We're going to bring the window down until we see the, okay, the bolts or clips that hold it in place. So bring the window down. Okay, check it out. A little bit more. Oh, right there. One bolt is here, one bolt is right there. 10 millimeter bolts, it looks like. So we can turn the ignition off. And now what do we need to do? We need to get a 10 millimeter socket, and we're going to remove these two bolts. Okay, and in some cases you just need to pre-loosen them a little bit. You don't need to take them all the way off. So let's see which design this one uses. Okay, that's it. Don't take it off all the way. Just 3-4 revolutions probably. Okay, now I want to grab the window. Okay, it's coming out. So at that point, all we have to do, pick the window, guys. Okay, pick the window with two hands. Okay, right here we need to remove the weather strip. Now let's pick that window. And you can, guys, gently, okay, pull it out in an angle. And your window came out just like that. For the next step, it's important to disconnect the car battery and wait for at least about an hour. Why? Because that's the side impact crash sensor right here, and we'll need to disconnect it. Every time you work on airbag sensors or anything like that, you need to have the car battery disconnected for at least 1 hour so the computers can actually discharge. And make sure, guys, you know what you're doing with airbag sensors. If you're not qualified and certified, I will not recommend it. So we'll go ahead, disconnect our car battery, and we'll continue with the next step. Car battery has been disconnected for about 1 hour. Now we can go ahead, okay, and pull that clip, push here, pull out. You can see, and it comes, okay, just like that. Now this sensor, I think it will just stay, okay, it will just stay right here. I don't think we need to actually go ahead and remove it. Now we need to pull the cables right here out of that bracket. Okay, remember the big one goes on top, little one on the bottom. You cannot mess them up, but just in case. What else we need to do? Okay, the window motor needs to come out right here. And this is the wiring harness for it as well. The speaker wire, we have it disconnected. Okay, this one here, you have this one. So all we have to do, press here and disconnect it. Perfect. You can see where it's located. Now window motor with Torx 20. Perfect, came out. Now, here, guys, we need to see, okay, we'll have quite a few wires here, and also we'll have a wire that goes to the door lock actuator here, so we'll see, okay, how that works. Let me just pull that seal. I want to see what we have here. That's where the wire goes to. So we will inspect and see how we're going to remove all that. So 10 millimeter socket, and we're going to remove, okay, that panel that holds everything. So let's do that. Perfect, quite a few bolts, right? Now, here, guys, you're going to grab it. It will be probably kind of like stuck because there is a seal. And if it hasn't been removed for a while, okay, it may be really, really stuck. We need to pull the wiring harness out now. Pull it out of the clips.
Okay, let's see if this one, if it's going to come out here or it's not. Everything is like super, super tight, guys. So, I wonder if we need to go ahead, okay, and pull it out of here a little bit too. See if we can gain a little bit of room. Okay, perfect. Okay, that wiring harness came loose. No? Okay, right here it's stuck. I can see the glue seal as well. You have the window regulator here, guys. So we need to bring it down now. Once you do that, you need to kind of like pull it down a little bit, because on two points you have the window regulator, the seals with the lock cable, and the cable for the release. Okay, is right here as well. Now, right here, guys. Okay, in some cases you might need to remove the door lock actuator. Okay, but now let's see. 1 second. I'm trying to see how things function here, because it looks like, guys, okay, we might need to remove the door lock actuator together with the thing, and in that case we'll need to remove the exterior door handle too. So now for the exterior door handle right here, guys, in order to remove it, we first need to remove that piece. Right here we have one cap, so we'll get a small screwdriver, okay, and hopefully don't mess our fingers. And if you look right here, okay, you have an 8, I believe it's an 8mm, guys, 8mm bolt that we need to actually pre-loosen. So let's go ahead, okay, and do that now. So, oh, let's go in more. Right there. Yep, 8mm, guys. So let's go ahead, get it loose, excuse me. I'll grab the lock cylinder here. A little bit more. Okay, let me see now. Okay, it came out. You can see like that. Screw it just a little bit so the bolt doesn't fall off. Now, right here, you grab that handle. Okay, let me see the design exactly. Okay, on this one here, to make sure that we don't... Okay, mess it up. But, yeah, it just slides towards the back. So it goes in, then you go back, you just tuck, and it comes out. You can see, just like that. That seal goes between the two pieces here. Next, what we need to do right here, guys, we have one bolt screw that we need to remove here for the interior door handle assembly. So let's go ahead and remove that one 8mm socket. Okay, yeah, that's good. We're taking it off. It's just a shallow bolt, shallow screw. Okay, that's okay. Let me see. I think that's good. You don't need to take it all the way off. You take it loose. Okay, and here, okay, let's remove those seals. Okay, perfect. Now, if you, okay, let me see now how it's going to go exactly. We might need to, okay, go ahead, okay, and remove now, okay, the door lock actuator. So let's go ahead, do that, and see if everything will release, and we'll see what we need to do after that. So it's always good to watch the video until the end, so you know exactly how it works, guys, because sometimes, okay, you think it's one way, you try to pry something, it breaks. So don't force things, always, okay, be careful. Now, we have 3 bolts here for the door lock actuator, okay, with the Torx 30, looks like it. Okay, Torx 30, start looking bit right here. Let's go ahead, remove this. Pretty tight. We need to get the ratchet to get them loose. Those little bolts are always tight, guys. And you need to install them tight as well. Sometimes they'll have thread locks, so they don't get loose from vibrations as well while you drive. So we'll see if that's the case with this. On other cars, I've noticed that often they'll have a thread locker. Perfect. Now, let's go ahead, get them loose. Yep, there is thread locker, guys. Almost every single time. Perfect. Now, right here. Okay, let's see now here. Okay, looks like, guys, okay, that screw will need to come out. Okay, I think this screw will just need to come out on this side, okay, in order to be able to remove it. So let's go ahead and push it or remove it all the way so we can see if we can put that handle in. Perfect. And you can see, okay, the handle moved now, okay, everything's loose on this side, actuator is loose, so now we need to see if we grab everything, if it's going to come out together as one assembly. Oh, one bolt got stuck here on the handle. Okay, perfect. Okay, I told you guys everything will come out together as one whole piece. So for the door lock actuator, you press here, you remove the cable, right? This is the first step. Then right here, we squeeze those in, okay, it comes out. Now right here, there is one tooth that we need to push in on the inside. Okay, it's on the other side, right here. Okay, let me hold the camera for a second and I'll show you how to do that now. So, okay, right here now. Okay, let me grab the tooth here. Okay, now, the only thing holding, okay, that point, is the cables, the cables right here. So we need to just, okay, put, they come out, I think. Just grab and pull a little bit. Perfect, okay, great. Now, the new one will come with a new cable, so you can just pry it out. Right here, guys, okay. Now, what do you need to do at that point? Okay, we need to open that cap. Okay, with a small screwdriver, open that cap. We need to disconnect the exterior door handle mechanism. We almost had it. It slides. Okay, let's go again. Okay, oh, let me see if we pry that thing. Okay, we're going to see in a second it will come out. First we need to remove the door handle, exterior door handle assembly right here. A couple clips. Oh, it went in. Let's see if we have a clip there. We don't, we just have the, okay, insulation holding. That later we're going to install. Okay, we have one on the inside right here. Let's do the one on the inside first and see if we can remove it that way. Okay, perfect. Now the one's on the outside. Okay, now let's inspect it here. Okay, there is one more that needs to come up. Okay, and it came out. Perfect. All we have to do now, it comes with a new cable, so you can disconnect it actually from this handle here, guys. Okay, that cable stays there. The new actuator, I think, comes with all three new cables that are brand new, guys. So all we have to do, okay, at this point, practically, is to disconnect, okay, that cable from right here. Perfect. Pull it out of the handle. Okay, and that's it. That's the door lock actuator. All we have to do, just feed your cables through the plastic and you're ready to go. You can see the two pieces are practically together. Whatever you needed to replace, exterior door handle mechanism, or if you needed to replace the door lock actuator. So that's how you guys remove, okay, the, you can see the door lock actuator or exterior door handle assembly on Hyundai Sonata. Putting it together, everything is in reverse order. We took it apart. If you have any questions, let us know. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.